First thing to do is to download the pattern. You can download that from my website. There's a link in the description. If you don't have a pattern of your own, or if you don't have my book from way back, it's there too. So I cut out the paper pattern and adjust it for the customer. None of us are size small, medium, large, or X-large. So some adjustment is always good. Take good measurement of your customer or of yourself. And find your fabric. So now I have cut out all the pieces to the coat in the main fabric and in the lining. Bella has bought very nice, almost vaatmel wool. It's quite dense. And for the lining, she uses silk. So she has been a very rich woman back then. It's never found, but I understand why she used it. I do too, because silk has similar quality to wool when it gets warm and moisturous. It's never cold and, what's it called, clamp? Wet. Linen gets cold and a little wet. You could also use very thin wool, so it's wool on wool. I look forward to sewing this. It's nice. But now, first I cut them out. They are cut out in exact same way. Normally I do the back piece a little bigger, but this time I will show you another way of sewing into the linen lining into the coat. On the coat for men, I've done it a little more common way, or modern common way maybe. I made two coats and sewn them together. In this one, I will line every piece and then in the end sew the pieces together. I have started a little. Here I have made the sleeve. It's the sleeves from Hedeby. And you can see here, every piece, I take every piece and sew them together. I'll show you this in the next chapter. But I'll sew them together, right side to right side, run in stitch, and just turn them inside out. And I sew so that the lining is always a few millimeters bigger than the main fabric. And that again, not to make the lining pull the coat in the wrong way. It gives you more freedom, it's more comfortable to wear. So first I've done that, and then I turn the right side out and I steam it. It's just because it's easier to work with them. And then I sew it together from the right side with invisible stitch. I'll show you. So it ends up looking like this. You can see, you can spread this out, and then you can see the main fabric through it. So they are individual pieces, all the pieces from the pattern sheet sewn together. That works also in square points like this. Works with no problem. But where it do not work is with the godet that are going into the back piece. This is the godet that is going into the back. Yeah. To make that point in that technique makes it too bulky up here. So for that reason, I do an exception for that technique here. I sew the godet into the back piece first, and then I do it that technique. So first thing first, I'll show you how I do the pointy. And it's, I know many avoid that, but it's just do it slowly, do it carefully. I'll show you how I do it. First thing, I have one of the measurements from Bella is from the shoulder here, where the neckline is, down to where she likes to have a belt. I don't know if she will have a belt on this, but that is one measurement and it goes to there. And to decide where the godet, where the godet will start and end, because sometimes you wear a belt, if it was a dress where you put in a godet, or even this one, the belt will be pulling up your dress coat a little. So I always place the point when it's finished sewn 2 centimeters below, almost an inch below. So I can take this one out now, and then I start cutting up in the center back to 1 centimeter from here. See, now I have cut up to 1 centimeter from the where I want it to end. And then I start one side. I always cut the top off. So I have 1 seam allowance, 1 seam allowance. I had 2 seam allowance there and 1 seam allowance there. That is the point. That is the top of the godet when it's finished. So I start putting in that point. And to make sure it's a sort of subconscious, if that is not exact, you will be annoyed when you walk behind the woman. You don't want to, you'll be happy. So to do it, exactly. It's not difficult at all. It's just to follow a few steps. You point 1 seam allowance, 1 seam allowance, 1 seam allowance. You pin through that, and you have the pin here exact where it should end. Let me take this one. And then now, when you shall put in the pin, if I just did normally as I do all other places, just putting it down and bending it, it will move 1 or 2 millimeters. And you will actually see that, or your subconscious will absolutely see it. So what I do, when I have it pointing down through everything, I hold my hand, my thumb, and my, what's that called? Index finger? Quite tight under it. And then I turn it. And put it in. Now that point is exactly where it should be, and the needle is going through it like that and then bending out. That is the trick, really. And then you, after maybe 2 inches, 5 centimeter, you are in 1 to 1, 1 1 here all the way down. Then you start sewing that. I seldom use knots, and for sure I will never use it here because it gets too bulky. And it's not strong enough either. Now it is important that you take this out, only one side, so it stands like that. And then follow the needle exactly in that point. That way down, not that way or that way, not like that. Pointing down through, directly through it. Then you can take out the needle. And now you can sew. The first I sew with running stitch, 2-3 millimeters. But the first in the point here, I sew 3 times on the top of each other. And every time, directly down, and then bend. Then you have a quite strong point there. Then run a stitch. Normally I sew with wool on everything, wool on wool. But in this coat, I do actually use synthetic. It might not be necessary in the Godet, but the rest of the coat will have only one seam that really put sew it together. There's only one seam here, so that I do with synthetic, a little strong thread. If you can get hold of strong hard spun wool, use that, of course. For me, it has also to do a little with my working, way of working. I work so much, I sew so much, and wool is more, there's more resistance. So I use my shoulder more with wool than I do with the synthetic things. That's also why, actually, with so many hours, I work often 12, 14 hours a day. It's good to have someone that don't kill your shoulder too much. So first, that one all the way down. And a cup of coffee. So now I've been sewing with running stitches all the way down. Here you see this nice structure it gives. What? So, now, remember before I started exactly where the point is going to be. So now I shall cut up there, to 1 millimeter, 2 millimeters from there. Oh, that was the wrong way to be. See, open up till 2 millimeters maybe from the point. And then turn this one in and do the same on the other side. And here you can see what you could see on the other side, that the seam allowance are not 1 centimeter or not where it should be in the beginning. See, only after 5 centimeter, again, I'm out in where it's 1 to 1, and all the way down. So now I start, as I did before, exactly in that point where I cut up to. Running stitch all the way down. So now both sides are sewn down. You see it's nice and pointy. First I cut off, it was square before, now I cut to the point. And then overcast with maybe 0.5 centimeter in between and pull. So you get that structure on the other side. I'm not stitching through this fabric. I'm only pointing down in it and up, so it, when I pull now, it will, there will come a little sort of hole or depth structure. And now I want to emphasize this point with those holes or structure. So make sure you do it in a straight line, which is not so hard to do because you just follow this all the way to the top. I always have my this finger under, so I just almost can feel the needle in it, and then I'm not going deeper than that. See, this is the point. Now I'm up in the level that. This is the same level as the point, but I continue. If this is the center, which I guess it is, I continue that line up till over the point. So I have that point and that point to emphasize the point. See? Now I'm coming up to the point. Then I'm actually going through. Not to make a stitch, just to make a hole exactly where it's supposed to be. You see, this line emphasized root, and now I'm going up on the top of the point, up and down, almost the same place, maybe half a millimeter next to it, just to make that structure up there. You see, there's the point, and here will be the point. And then I go down again. Just make sure that you pull so you get that structure. See? And then overcast all the way down again, of course. Down. And after that, we should put in the lining in this piece. All right, I should do the same with the lining, of course, the green silk. And then after that, I will show you how to put in the lining to each piece. This is Simba.